one, let's go look for the case REZ, that is 2015-17 Brandon project.
Yes, this particular subject property, we actually saw, I believe it was back in 2007. It was rezoned to R1, a 1-acre lot residential in the area. With that, it sat, I won't say dormant, but it was not developed at that intensity. The property was recently sold, and the developer has come to us and is interested in changing the zoning from a 1-acre density to a 1/2-acre density, which is R21. With that, staff looked at this request, and ultimately, we looked at the changing conditions of the area, which is they wrote from the school to the north, as well as it's not very widespread knowledge yet, but the county is currently undergoing installing water and sewer along Lester Road in an attempt to serve Lowndes Middle School to the west. So with those recent improvements and the future plan for zoning residential, we believe that we could support R21. That being said, we did have to clarify the conditions of approval that felt like were necessary on this particular case. But ultimately, our recommendation was for approval with two conditions. I did have an update to one of the conditions that you have before you today, and I'm sorry that the language is very much not readable on this particular presentation. Matt and I tried to combine things before we were supposed to attend up there. But ultimately, the first condition has to deal with interior loss. We did feel like that was necessary on this case. The change was that since the subject property is developed currently with one resident, we felt like it was appropriate to let that residence have a lot on Copeland Road rather than saying you couldn't have any lots on Copeland. But the only change for the condition is the first condition changes, we're recommending it be changed to one lot shall be allowed to front Copeland Road, all other lots shall front interior. That was the change as opposed to the email we sent earlier this week. Applicants lifted that issue up, so that was the change for that condition. Second condition did not change. It deals with the improvement of Lester Road. If they pull any driveways off of it, we do not expect them to pull driveways off of it. We felt like with Lester Road being unpaved, we needed some protection. With that, the only other updates I have are to the opposition on the case. I've received a few phone calls with concerns about the change in density of the area, as well as the county commission received one letter late this afternoon that I've only gotten by email. I don't have actual physical copies. And so I will tell you, it looks like it's from one of the neighbors to the east. It's signed by three people, and their main concerns are density, traffic congestion, and potentially more trash in the area. And so with that, I apologize for not having physical copies, but I want to let you know that I did receive one letter and a few phone calls since our work session last week. So, sure. Yes, sir. Second condition, and thank you, Commissioner Paulson, has to do with the paving. If there are any proposed entrances off of Lester Road, then the developer will be required to pave Lester Road from the entrance to Copeland Road. The developer will also be responsible for the design, any acquisition of necessary right-of-way, relocation of utilities, and construction costs for the paving of Lester Road and the development's southernmost entrance to Copeland Road. Again, the intent there is to make sure that the developer is aware that if they access Lester Road, the county expects it to be paved. We don't anticipate that access, but we felt like the coverage is still something we wanted to record. With that, that's all the updates I have on the conditions. In opposition, but the ultimate recommendation of staff is still approval with the conditions we have that have been updated for that interior lot condition.
Case that paving would be Lester Road just to be paved by Copeland Road?
Yes, sir. We think that that developer would probably naturally want to pave north if they did that because south in the perimeter is just further for longer distance.
Commissioners, any questions for staff or Mr. Bowman?
Just your first condition there. In our packet, there's an aerial photo of the site.
Yes, sir.
There's a house showing some of the only approval of the parcel. Is that in it for that house? So that house is going to stay?
Yes, sir. We expect. R21
developed?
We do. The preliminary plan we've seen are a large lot in the middle that they want to deal with the front of Copeland, surrounded by a U shaped subdivision with two tiers of lots around that area. So those preliminary plans are exactly that preliminary, but that's the layout we see. It's kind of a U-shaped street system around that central walk.
Should you or should we condition that condition current improvement plan, because the current improvement's going down, you don't necessarily need a lot of funding to cover that.
Sure could. I mean, I think the applicant's agent probably could speak to maybe clarify that, but yes, sir, we could, y'all could absolutely do that.
Mayor Glavine?
Yeah, Jason, how many lots is this approximately, what lots to?
Do you have that layout also, Jason? We had a meeting with them, a pre-app meeting. The original indication they gave us, Commissioner, was for 21 lots. And this was their, you know, preliminary layout. I'll pass this around, but we had a meeting with them where they said, okay, well, this is what we are thinking. They didn't turn it as an official site plan, so we haven't reviewed it as, you know, making sure it meets all our standards. But typically, I'll pass this around. This is what they submitted to us. And I believe it was for 21 lots.
Jason, you mentioned that the sewer and water is in the plan, but these will be built with wells and septic tanks?
The developer can comment more about why they didn't go with like an R10 versus an R21 zone. But ultimately, we expect these lots to use both water and sewer. We believe the water and sewer infrastructure, I think the current due date is the end of the year. So that is going to supersede when they actually develop and cut these lots up.
So they will be on sewer?
Yes, sir. We expect these to be utilized in both county water and sewer.
All right, well, my concern, half acre lots.
Yeah, yes, sir. A county community water system and a septic tank is typically what you would see with this style of development, but we don't believe those are the development plan. We think he made his decisions in another direction.
Okay.
Thank you. Is this TRC single?
Yes, sir. Ultimate recommendation was the approval with two conditions, and they had the meeting. The pre-app meeting was, I want to say, within the last month for TRC, sir.
I was just curious, did it require two phases?
24 losses, or 25 losses.
Triggers it?
Yes, sir. So they're very close, but ultimately, I think the design. Again, I think the developer's agent will speak to this. It has to do with not wanting to pave Lester Road and also trying to accommodate for that two-lot scenario. So I think they tried to work that to get as many lots as they could without triggering that paving requirement.
Commissioners, any other questions for staff? I'll have to take a look at that.
Why can't they, instead of having the turnaround there to one end, why can't they connect that to Coburn Road?
That was one of staff's questions as well. And that, remember, I shouldn't say remember, at the meeting they presented this to us, so one of our comments was definitely, you know, why not run that road into Copeland like a U for traffic flow?
Exactly.
I think the developer's engineer or surveyor was concerned about that entrance being too close to Lester. So that's why they wanted to work on that layout to maybe move that the west if that does happen. But I believe that will be a good improvement as well. I think they're just concerned about those two streets being so close.
Any other questions for Mr. Staff? If there being none this time, we will open up to anybody wishing to speak in favor of this request. If you will, sir, also you give us your name and address for the record, please.
My name is Rodney Timmer, 107 East North Street, Mr. Brown on this project. Any questions for the
Commissioner, any questions for the presenter?
Are you familiar with the two conditions of our new apartment?
Aye.
You are?
Sir.
I go back to that question about having a U-shaped road through there. How close would that entrance be to Lester Road there?
Right now, I can't select right off. Okay. What you have is a very rough preliminary.
Right.
So it's an ideal.
Yeah. Well, I just, you know, it's if you're back in that back cul-de-sac and you're waiting on a fire truck to get back there, It might be something that, like, should put in as a condition, or at least highly recommended it be a U-shaped drive instead of a cul-de-sac in that, corner.
Cul-de-sacs are found on through traffic a lot. I live on a cul-de-sac, I prefer that to have a through street, but it's just a matter of preference.
Yeah.
I've got no problem with it, too.
Commissioners, any questions for presenter anymore? Thank you. Is there anyone else wishing to speak in favor of this request? Anyone else wishing to speak in favor? There being none, is there anyone here wishing to speak in denial of this request? Anyone wishing to, yes, sir? Please come forward and state your name and your address for reference, sir.
My name is Rick Hitch. I live at 3001 Webster Road. By the way, just not that bad.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay if I pass that around?
Yeah.
They can see it.
Well, I said my name's Rick Hitch. I would like to start out by saying I didn't receive a public hearing notice in the mail. Whatever. But all the other guests received the notice in the government 921. Otherwise, my family and surrounding neighbors wouldn't have heard about this, which is not enough time for people to think that to respond or have enough time to do anything about it. We built our home there on 3001 Webster Road about a year ago. After moving from subdivision to Brooks County, which hoops not being in some of them to fact ill. And this project is it proposes to work a slap in the face. We are against this proposal altogether. All the surrounding properties are a fair amount of the size of acres. And no half acre lots among us. We got 19.2 acres where we can. My father got 30 acres over on the other side. And it's 6 acres right on the west side. And we also have 2 ponds on our property. And the neighbor, Mr. Dallas, said he's got a pond on his property. We know that the proposed subdivision, there will never be more children of all ages, which would be concerned with safety, privacy would be an issue. No one would put the proximity in the subdivision. Another issue of concern would be the traffic in this location. Without the middle school being cut the road, something will start back there. Traffic is already an issue. So why does it or even can't travel or take our children to school that way in the morning or afternoon? With the subdivision involved, this is going to make an already congested area even worse. We already have people turning around on this road in the car driveway.
One question I want to ask, I guess, if you don't mind, and you said you live across the street from the proposed development?
I live behind it.
Behind it, but on the same side as Lester Road, not across the street, but behind it?
Right. live behind it. My family's got the land across from that road, but I live directly behind it. And these lots are going to be right in the back of the, house, and we're facing it. And I was sort of off to myself there.
Any questions for the Commissioner Paulson?
I'm just still trying to get my mind straight, but on that map up there, you see the property outline. Who would be below that?
I would be below that. It don't serve our household.
Where'd you say your father, where is he?
He, my father is just to the right of that property. Wraps around and puts that in the book.
Across Lester Road. And you said there's 600 lot.
That's where I. There's no, nothing with that small fire from there, so right.
Is the property that Mr. Gans talked about, his father, is that the property that's already?
Yes, sir, to the east.
That's what his father owns? Father and brother, is what he's saying?
Oh, I'm sorry, it's EA to the east where he's talking about his father's property, and then that RA to the west, those are two other adjacent areas. His property is to the south. His father's property is to the east.
Is the middle school in the triangle there between the tracks on the ground or the car?
Yes, it's, if you look on the aerial, right across the street is, a stand at Pecan Street. West of those Pecan Street is where Clemens is. So the property is, the middle school property is quite large, but the development is on the west side of the property. So that purple OI color is where the development is. It's further to the west on that purple area.
Purple area.
Is the Lowndes Middle School property. But their development is actually on the western edge of that middle school, of that property. Yes, sir. Lowndes County, Lowndes School property is that entire purple area. But out of that acreage, which is across the street, let's just call that 200 acres, the existing Lowndes Middle School is all the way on that western edge of that property towards those residential neighborhoods to the west. So it's almost across the street from the west. Yes.
Commissioner Glad?
Well, actually, I have a question for staff. So.
Please.
If you, Jason, R1, which is what this property is currently zoned as, what is that? What's the size of a lot in R1 designation?
In this area, you know, minimum of 1 acre in size. Do you mean like wet width and depth?
No, I mean, what I would like is a comparison between R1 and R21.
Oh, yes, ma'am. R1 is 1 acre minimum. R21 is a half acre minimum. They both have the same lot width on a water system or county water, which is 100 feet in width.
That's a minimum, Jason?
Yes, minimum.
The properties that are to the west, directly adjacent to the west, which is in that orange there, RA,
yes.
Those are probably 5 acres minimum?
2.5. However, I believe one of those properties adjacent to the road is less than 2.5 acres. You can see it; it's a smaller piece of property developed for the residents.
It don't have as much width, but I see it nowadays.
That's right.
Yes.
We processed the family ties request related to that property within the last 10 years, where it actually broke that property. So you have some larger lots to the rear, and I think one smaller lot to the very front.
But that was
basically. Family ties, yes, sir. Family ties.
On this zoning map that we have, directly to the south of the property, in our map, it shows white. Is that an easement or is that an actual, is that part of the rural PA zoning?
We believe that strip probably should actually be rezoned or be zoned R10. We think that was just a mapping discrepancy from an old zoning case. We raised that that was raised as a part of our conversations with Mr. Rick too about why that EH strip is there. Right now, my guess is that that strip should actually be R10. That's where the EH should not be there. That this property is R1, that R10 should actually be above.
And what is
R10?
The size of the lot?
With water and sewer, you could go down to 10,000 square foot lots.
Okay. Directly
south of that, which is in Netto, which is R10, correct? So the property of
this company right now is
zoned currently
R10.
R10. But
if it happens to be above.
That's right. Our minimums are only
minimums.
You can certainly go above that.
And the future development map plans for that area to be eventually a suburban area. So what is currently being proposed is in line with the future development map. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am. We expected this area to be developed suburban residentially. We didn't realize that the water sewer plans would be so aggressive. We didn't expect the plan this area to be served by water and sewer for some time. So that was a change in the county's position on this area.
Thank you. Do you have anything else you
want
to say, Mr.
Paulson,
please?
Mr. Gasser, we didn't make you feel any better doing the vegetated buffer along the back.
If we have. But, yeah, rather not. Last case, if it did get through, then we need some kind of good book. It's both for it. If we did have a free look.
Is there any, there's nothing there now.
There's nothing there now.
I'm just curious, on this overhead shot, is that trees that we see, Jason? Or?
Yes, sir. And I believe those trees are actually probably Mr. Guest's tree. I don't know they're on Mr. Brandon's property.
Which tree?
I know that there's pecan trees on Mr. Brandon's property, but I think the thick pines are probably on Mr. Guest's property.
is that trees on your property?
Yeah, pine trees.
Pine trees. So there is a pine tree buffer there present.
They scattered. They have the sea rocks
over. Mr. Paulson, what's your thoughts on that? Anything?
I was just thinking we have like one to put up on the southern side.
Is there anything in the current regulations to put up?
Not between these two residential densities. It's something we could definitely handle through probably a rezoning commission.
May I?
Please, ma'am.
The overall concern seems to be the increase in density and the impact of that on the traffic in the northern roads. Is that correct? More than the having a buffer between residential neighborhoods. Is that correct?
Yes,
ma'am. So where does the county stand as far as the traffic that may be generated from this development? Is there a concern on along Copeland Road that's going to be, is there a concern of traffic?
With 21 or less than 25 lots, we did not have a concern. The overall development in the area of Clowns Middle School, I mean, certainly at peak hours in the morning and the afternoons, as Mr. Guest alluded to, traffic is an issue on Copeland for those peak hours, absolutely. So overall, for this development to trigger something extra, no. But this area during those peak traffic times during school, you know, being started and ending, it's certainly there's traffic in here. Back up on Copeland Road, I have traffic waiting to kind of clear the school traffic.
And the congestion just comes kind of directly across the street from the school.
Yes, sir. I mean, one of the very things that makes it markable is that one of the things that is going to make it certainly less attractive, you know, certainly something on the radar.
Any questions for presenter? Thank you, Mr.
Gaines. I was going to say, you want to try to drive that couple road 42 and 3 o'clock in the afternoon? Just going.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah.
Commissioners? Any discussion amongst ourselves on this request? Any discussions, Commissioner? If no discussions, I am ready to take a motion on this request, 2015-17.
I know, that's what I get for providing that presentation. I was just trying to avoid getting that opening. Sure. If there are any proposed entrances off of Lester Road, then the developer will be required to pave Lester Road from the entrance to Coburn Road. The developer will also be responsible for the design, any acquisition of necessary right-of-way, relocation of utilities, and construction costs for the paving of Lester Road from the development's southernmost entrance to Coburn Road.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a recommendation that we approve case REZ 2015-17 and recommend approval to the County Commission with the existing conditions.
Okay, we have a motion from Commissioner Hall of approval with the existing conditions. Do I have a second? Motion failed. Do we have an alternative motion at this time?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion that we request an island this request to the County Commission.
Okay, we have a motion from Commissioner Wiles of denial of this request. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second. Commissioner Rankin, all in favor, please signify by raising your right hand. All opposed? 5-1, Mr. Carmella. The next case this evening is REZ 2015-18.